Hello there and welcome to the Stomping Ground Kickoff Show. This is your host, this is your boy, this is your guy, this is your person that's behind the mic today. It is Ricky and I'm here to break down what is coming up here, which is Stomping Grounds, the Raw exclusive pay-per-view. And in this pay-per-view, it's going to be a night that Monday Night Raw has needed for a while. A night to end feuds, a night to crown champions, a night for champions to be defended. The ending of a rivalry that's been going on and on and on. And it's coming to an end tonight. By that, I mean Sasha Banks and Charlotte in a steel cage match. But I will break down every single match. And we will also have two matches here on the kickoff show, and we will let you know which ones they are here tonight. But let's get right down to it. Let's start partying. Let's figure out what the matches tonight are going to be on the main show. And the first match, please roll out the card. It will be for the United States Championship. It will be Bobby Lashley, Shinsuke Nakamura, AJ Styles challenging against the champion Drew McIntyre in a fatal four-way for the United States Championship. Something's got to give. These are four of the best that Monday Night Raw has to offer, and they're competing for the United States Championship, a championship that is showered in history. History naming names are on that championship list of people who've held that championship, and Drew McIntyre believes that he is the superior of the superior of the superior, and the name of those people who have held that championship. But tonight, facing three of the best that Raw has to offer, this could be the biggest challenge for Drew McIntyre till date. He took that championship away from Shinsuke Nakamura. Nakamura took it away from Styles. Styles took a Universal Championship away from Lashley. This is all just based in controversy, and it is beautiful. But we'll see you here on Stomping Grounds tonight from Monday Night Raw. Ladies and gentlemen, I cannot wait for this one. I cannot. I just got to break it down like that. And then we have the Women's Intercontinental Championship defended in six women elimination style. So this means pretty simple. Everyone needs to be eliminated in order for you to win this match. And Nikki Bella, the champion, is going to have her toughest challenge. Yes, this is all because she was she had a match against Mickie James where she disqualified herself and said, hey, I don't have to defend my championship anymore. And I did not think this decision would come through from Stephanie and Triple H, but they said, hey, we can't have that going around. So now she's defending the championship against another five women here that Raw definitely... Oh, man, I'm telling you, Raw is a better roster than SmackDown here. It's Lacey Evans, Paige, AJ Lee, Ronda Rousey, and Alexa Bliss. Paige and AJ Lee are former women's champions. Alexa Bliss, a former Intercontinental champion. Ronda Rousey, a former UFC champion. And Lacey Evans, the prodigy of Mickie James. Coming up, this is going to be a tough challenge for Nikki Bella. And it's not going to be easy. I'm going to throw that down for her. And she knows that this is going to be the toughest challenge. But elimination style could benefit her. Because, again, she has to be pinned to be eliminated to lose the championship. So she could just hang out on the outside the whole time and wait for all these women to eliminate each other. But up next, it's going to be a tag team championship matchup with three of the best teams on Monday Night Raw. This is going to be a crucial battle for the tag team division. The Usos, the New Day, the Revival, the Champions, the New Day have been looking a little bit off. Let's just throw that off. The last match they had with Xavier and Big E, it did not go the way they wanted. Big E was taken out of the equation very easily. It just took him out, and I was like, what is going on here? But the Usos believe it's their time. The Revival believe it's their time. The New Day still don't think their time is up. With these three teams here, this is going to be a triple threat tag team matchup. First team to get the pinfall, or I've also been told it's an elimination style too, but it's keep it secret. I'm supposed to keep that secret, but it's possibly an elimination style where everyone eliminates everyone, and that's the way you'll crown a champion. We'll see when the time does come up to see what kind of matchup that is. But the Raw Tag Team Division right here on full display. These are three of the best teams, and I don't know what happens after this. This is a big one right here. This is a big match for the Raw Tag Team Championship. But let's go up into the next one, which is definitely the most controversial matchup. The one that's been just like, it just happened this past week on Raw. We just announced Finn Balor will defend his championship against Rey Mysterio. Finn Balor just defended that championship against Broken Matt Hardy on Monday Night Raw, and he won. He was victorious as the demon was unleashed. But according to the the Raw upper-ups, which Stephanie McMahon and Triple H, they believe that, hey, we need a Universal Championship matchup at Stomping Grounds, and we're going to put someone who's been a former champion, a former WWE champion, a former world champion, a man who is a future solidified Hall of Famer, Rey Mysterio and Finn Balor, in their first ever encounter. Stomping Grounds will be the night, and a lot of people believe it's just to keep Rey happy, to keep Rey happy on the Raw brand, where he hasn't been succeeding as much. Yes, he's had a couple of victories here and there, but it's not been victories that should define a Universal Championship. But this is definitely a match that is based in controversy, but I can't wait to see the first encounter between Rey Mysterio and Finn Balor. It should be amazing. And a match that will kick off our kickoff show, it's going to be Andrade versus Humberto Carrillo. Andrade threw a proposition for Humberto Carrillo, and it hasn't been working well for him because nobody has accepted it yet. He got his ass beat a couple days ago on ECW. And now Humberto Carrillo is going to get the chance to take down Andrade. But Andrade said, hey, you beat me, I leave you alone. I leave you alone. I will leave you alone. But if you lose to me, then you become my bag boy and you become my servant. And this is definitely a matchup that has great potential if you are into the Lucha Libre kind of style types of matches. And these two will start the night off here at the kickoff show. And what I'm hearing is Humberto Carrillo has a lot to prove. This is his first big matchup here in the WWE. And Andrade wants to leave Monday Night Raw with a big statement win. And without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, I am hearing these two gentlemen are ready to go, and we're going to go down to ringside to get this match started. Enjoy Stomping Grounds kickoff. And ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the first match in the kickoff show. It will be Andrade versus Humberto Carrillo, and this is definitely a chance to see the future of Monday Night Raw in Humberto Carrillo against a man who is on his way out, on his way to ECW after signing a lucrative contract with ECW. Zelina Vega will stay on Monday Night Raw and will be part of ECW. She will follow Andrade to ECW as well, but she'll also be on Monday Night Raw. And I got the chance to speak with Zelina earlier today, and she's got expansion on the mind. Says, hey, why not? Why do I only have to have one client dominating WWE when I can have multiple on multiple different brands? And apparently we are in the beginning of the Zelina Vega era. And the young kid from Monterrey, Mexico, is going to have to pull all the stops tonight. Yes, the old saying, pull up all the stops. This is going to have to be a big showing tonight from Humberto, because he's going up against the toughest challenge to date here. Yes, the gentleman has been a part of 205 Live NXT, but this is his biggest match on Monday Night Raw. And this is what the kickoff show is all about, giving young talent like Humberto Carrillo a chance to shine on the pay-per-view level. You know, and this is his stop here with Andrade. Two men. Here we go. Andrade starting off right there with that move right there, real quick and real fast to the point. And look at Andrade. This is the tranquilo style. He does not. Yes, Amanda takes this seriously, but he does it so calmly and so cool. And look at Humberto's like, forget this. I'm just gonna throw caution into the wind and let's go. And that's what you don't want to do as the younger opponent here. Umberto, yes, he's experienced in the wrestling world, but it's a different style again, like we've said here before in the WWE. You don't want to get too ahead of yourself, especially against someone as seasoned as Andrade. Andrade knows that, hey, it's not a race, it's a marathon. And look at Andrade with that moonsault on the down Umberto. That hurts you still, even if you're delivering the moonsault. It still hurts to drop your body into that position on a down opponent, but it hurts your opponent even more. As right now, Andrade now trying to get the better of Umberto, but Umberto crashes right into him. That's smart by Umberto, not allowing Andrade to continue his game plan. And look at Umberto right now, unleashing the fury of strikes that he wants to do here. And now where is Umberto? Oh, look at Umberto's a star, man. Look at this young kid, the speed, the quickness. He is Dale Gas, baby. I don't know what that means, but I'm just going to say it. I know what it means, but I don't know what kind of context they're trying to use it in. Okay, leave me alone. Suplex by Andrade, though, switches it up back to his style. And again, like I said, Andrade will keep it calm and pace to his liking. However, Andrade wants to control the matchup. That's how he will do this. And Andrade Cien Almas picking up Umberto and a smack across the face. Another smack. Again, these smacks to the young kid, Umberto, who doesn't have a manager here. He does tag team with his cousin, Angel Garza, but in the last couple days, last couple weeks, hasn't been paradise for both those cousins. And oh, look at that! And Andrade thought he dodged a kick, but the speed of Umberto to deliver another kick. The young kid might have pulled up the upset. No, a 2.5 count real quick right there. What a way to start off the night here. This is the kickoff show for Stomping Grounds, but let that take nothing away. These gentlemen will fight like this is the main event of Stomping Grounds. And speaking of the main event, yes, that's right. What a transition I pulled off right there. You're welcome. That was terrible, but you're welcome. We will have a steel cage match for the Raw Women's Championship when Sasha Banks takes on the challenger, the Queen, Charlotte Flair. The Raw Championship will be on the line. The Raw Women's Championship will be on the line when those ladies go up against each other in the main event here on Stomping Grounds. Andrade has taken control here again. Now Umberto again switching it up. And again, the young kid gets switched up here by Andrade. And like I said, Andrade is calm. His calm demeanor is what's going to help him here get the win if he does pick up the win. Umberto needs to slow it down a little bit. I know he wants to get his hand. Oh, look at, there you go. Andrade doing a lot of trash talking. And Umberto's like, all right, well, that's what you want to do. I'm going to deliver some kicks while you're on the ground defenseless. That's just smart right there. Why would you talk all that trash just to get kicked in the face? And oh, drop kick there by Umberto. Umberto. Whoa, look at the helicopter right there. And no, Mulligman, no. No manos. No hands, right? That's what it is. Yeah, I'll play with me. Andrade counters that right now. Umberto thought he was going to get control of this, but look at the height Andrade got on that drop kick. And it's going to go for the pinfall. Why the hell not? It landed perfectly on Umberto, but a kick out by Carrillo, and Carrillo surviving so far right now against Andrade. And Umberto with the kick to the midsection right there to Andrade. Oh, look at this moonsault! The kid just said, I'm going to do whatever I have to do. Anything I have to do to pick up the win is what I have to do. And right now, the pinfall, the win. Now Andrade kicks at it 2 again. These close calls are coming in real quick right now. And the ref's like, hey, I'm counting, man. I know how to count. I can count in Spanish, too, if you want me to. Uno, dos, tres. But there's no tres there, just the 2. And look at Vega! And Vega getting involved in this matchup. You got to be kidding me, ref. I know you want to throw the DQ in there, but Umberto's telling the ref, don't do it. Don't throw it in there. Don't throw the DQ in. I still want this one. And Andrade runs over Umberto. And Umberto trying to pick himself up here. And Andrade, again, taunting it so calmly. This is what he's all about. Andrade now, look at this. Twist, neck breaker. And that knocks down Umberto. Umberto, you should have won this one already, but you told the referee, don't throw the disqualification. It's fine. He's like, don't. And the referee, listen, that was just a dumb move. You could have picked up a win against Andrade here tonight. And Andrade coming in. He faked out Umberto, but did not technically fake out Umberto because Umberto still saw right through it and was able to counter it now. Umberto now throws Andrade out of the ring, and Zelina Vega trying to get to no! Oh, my God, Umberto! Oh, got countered! What?
What a counter by Andrade. How did he counter a freaking moonsault headed right towards him? Must have been Vega telling him, hey, you've got him coming right at you. And now Humberto now is back to control of it. But either way, what a counter by Andrade. Now Humberto's like, okay, let's see you work with this one again. And now look at Humberto with that I don't even know what to call it, but it's just so beautiful when he jumps off the ropes like that and flies like that. The Grandma Lake approves. And now Humberto Carrillo with an elbow. Another elbow to the face. More elbows to the face here could work against a guy like Andrade, as these elbows are connecting and they're making sure they connect and they're making sure they hit. As right here, this is still not Andrade's matchup. That's elbows. He loves these elbows, man. Smart though. You're hitting him right in the head. He's not aware of what's going on. Could be trying to break his tranquilo style. And now Humberto Carrillo goes for it again. And I'm telling you, I love this maneuver. I don't care how many times I see it. It's third time tonight, but it's a beautiful maneuver still from Humberto Carrillo. It's difficult to do. Difficult to do three times in a match, just even one time. It's difficult. It's a match where it's bad. Your feet get caught in the middle of the ropes, and then you're done. And look at Humberto right here, taking the fight to the outside on the hardest part of the bring the back beam drop. And now Vega trying to, what is she is talking to Humberto out there, trying to say, hey, you need to stop this. But Humberto Carrillo not getting distracted, and that's smart. You cannot be distracted by Vega on the outside. We'll do whatever she needs to do to get her client the upper hand. And Humberto Carrillo with elbows again. The young kid fighting with everything, man. The kid from Monterrey, Mexico is doing whatever he needs to do to beat Andrade here. And this is Andrade in the corner. What is Humberto waiting for? Humberto, this is now you pulling an Andrade move out. What are you doing, Humberto? And Andrade's like, come on, attack me. And Humberto's like, all right. An elbow to the face that will bring it down to the ground. More elbows to the face. And now Humberto Carrillo. What? Oh, no. Vega this time. I don't know if Vega can count. Maybe this is going to be counted again. Oh, moonsault. What a moonsault. What a moonsault to the outside, baby. That's not a moonsault. That's a freaking front flip, you idiot. God damn, I'm terrible with these moves today. As the kid that Dale Gas is ready to do his thing here. Picking him up here. Suplex, if I call the move right. Suplex. Oh, look at him. No, jackhammer. What the f***? I didn't know Humberto knew the jackhammer, but he does. And that could be the win. Oh, kick out there by Andrade. Oh, how do you not? That beats anyone. The jackhammer is the most deadliest move in all of wrestling. And Andrade kicked out of it. I kicked to the midsection. And now Humberto. Oh, smack to the face. Wow. The disrespect from Andrade, man. It's true. It's damn true. Suplex, Northern Light suplex right there. And Andrade with the pinfall. Kick out though by Humberto. And Andrade not going to let that shake him, as he's going to drop the hammer, the punches, down on Humberto. And now that Andrade has control of the matchup, where is he going to go with this? He's going high risk. Oh, what is this? What is this? Oh, golly, a flat. That just lays him down flat. And look at Andrade talking the smack while Humberto's down on the ground. Again, there's nothing that stops this man. This man is the same from the beginning to the end of the match. Same intensity, just calm and in his estilo, tranquilo. And a kick to the midsection there. Now Humberto using a side kick right there. Oh, Humberto Carrillo pulling out some moves I haven't seen in a while from the young kid. And the kid, a kick out there though by Andrade. Humberto is thinking that's got to be it. He's like, that's my win. That's my chance to walk out of here with a W. What a match here tonight in the kickoff show here. Oh, we always see good action here on the kickoff shows here. Monday Night Raw especially, because Monday Night Raw rules, you know. But a shot to that. A slap. I don't know if it's hurting as much. There is a shirt that has it there, but I'm not sure if it hurts as much. It still hurts, but I don't think, you know, not connecting as much as if it was a just, you know. You know what I mean. Thank you for understanding that. Let's continue as Andrade now trying to put the DDT to the end. No, Humberto says, I've studied that move and I got out of it. Counter, and now Humberto turns it around. Oh, wait a second, execution.
Well, that's a chair. That's a chair that executes you. And maybe they'll win a rope break. Don't buy Andrade grabbing the ropes. The electric chair is what you were thinking of. One, that's what you were thinking of. And right now, Humberto Carrillo has turned this crowd alive, chanting for him, waiting for him, letting him know, hey, get this win, man, get this W, you deserve it. And look at the high. Oh no! Andrade says, get that out of my house. Andrade power slams the poor kid. And Andrade now has control of the matchup here. And now he's going to use that middle rope as a weapon. Bam! Right there. Oh, the midsection hitting that right there. Now Andrade has control of the poor kid here. And the kid, Northern Lights suplex, pinfall. And there's a chance that this could be a no kick out there by Humberto. Humberto Carrillo thinking he's got a chance to survive. Thinking he's got a chance to continue his path here. And look at Andrade delivering punches to the cornered Humberto. More punches here. Now Andrade, oh, he's lining up, he's sizing it up. He's telling Humberto there's no getting out of this. Nice to the face of Humberto. That smile ain't going to be the same after tonight. Now Andrade, what is Andrade thinking here? There's a down Humberto. Andrade, whoa! He went for something, but no, I think Humberto got him with the knees. He caught knees to the midsection of Andrade. And now power slam. And now Humberto. Oh, but look at Andrade rolling to the outside. But Humberto's like, it's not going to stop me from doing what I got to do. Humberto drops the hammer elbow on him. That's just an elbow being dropped on your face. And now Vega trying to get involved in this one. Ref needs to put more authority on this. Hey, you almost got, you know, this match was almost thrown out because of Vega once. And Humberto bringing Andrade back into the ring. And what do you do if you're the young kid waiting for your chance, your moment to put down Andrade? Elbow to the back of Andrade. Delivers it well. And now kick to the midsection. DDT! A DDT! Maybe the win! This is a Jake the Snake Roberts used to get wins back in the day. And no! Andrade says that's not going to be good enough against me here tonight. Now Andrade counters it. Power slams Humberto and changes the direction of this matchup as Andrade now went for a big smack. There was nothing there. Humberto now figures it's something that has to give here. Big kick to the midsection, a kick to the side of the head. And Andrade better watch himself. Humberto's trying to do whatever he can, man, to get this win. A running sidekick there. And there is no doubting that tonight Humberto Carrillo has stepped out of the shadows. And Humberto, moonsault, no miss, no way. Oh, he got it! He got it! And he might have gotten the best of Andrade. No! A kick out at 2.5. Humberto Carrillo coming out of the shadows tonight. And this is why these kickoff shows, wait a second, these kickoff shows are so important to guys like Humberto Carrillo. Time to shine. But Andrade says, your time to shine is over. And I am walking out. Oh, a kick out by Humberto. And Andrade, upset about that. Upset about that. And right now, Andrade is sizing him up. Andrade sizing up, but Humberto is not going to give up this opportunity to show the world where he belongs. Humberto Carrillo, who we've seen on 205 Live, but now here on Monday Night Raw, able to give the world a chance to see the young, promising Latino superstar. And Humberto Carrillo, a kick out though by Andrade. And Andrade showing again why there's a bidding war for him between ECW and Raw. And he missed that move there. And Humberto better capitalize right there. But now, again, Andrade, who was very good in NXT, and now trying to do that on Monday Night Raw and ECW, wherever he decides to to lace the boots up. They're going to win. But Humberto right now wants to have Andrade go off on a bad note here. And Humberto Carrillo going for it again. Humberto is going to go for this move. And we've seen it before. He does. No, this is different. Humberto drop kick missed. He missed. That's not good. Either Andrade got out the way. But look at Andrade again taking control. And Andrade. Suplex right there by Andrade. And Humberto trying to buy himself some time. Going to the outside to avoid any pin combinations. And now Andrade says, yeah, that's fine. Oh, hanging DDT. And look at the body of Humberto Carrillo. Might have taken a pretty big shot there. And the rope break of Humberto Carrillo. That's smart. That's a smart move by Humberto. No one would fault him for doing that. And Andrade, you can tell he's a little upset that happened. But look at Humberto Carrillo. I love Humberto. He's never going to give up. And Humberto Carrillo says, I'm going to fight till I got nothing left in the tank. And Dropkick City from Carrillo. And Humberto thinking to himself, what can I do here? And, oh, I don't know. Yo, high-risk maneuver again. Humberto, you've done this once. You've done... Oh, moonsault! Yes! Get the pin, kid! Humberto is about to walk out of Stomping Grounds. Get the all kick out by Andrade. And Andrade trying to go for a big punch and nothing there. Nothing landed. Humberto is still in control here. Carrillo with the match in control. And look at Humberto here. What is this by Humberto? Oh, look at the stand. Boom! The athletic ability of Humberto Carrillo being displayed, the luchador style, and Humberto Carrillo did it! Oh! Oh! He did it! Humberto Carrillo defeats Andrade! Big win for the kid! Like I said, these kickoff shows always so huge for young talent like Humberto Carrillo to prove they belong, to prove they should be every single week on Monday Night Raw. And Humberto Carrillo, the old guys, that old guys, and he gave it, and he has defeated Andrade. Andrade, you lost, buddy. We still got one more match, but guess what? We're going to send it back. We're going to send it back to the recaps and to build up what is left, what you can see tonight on Stomping Grounds. Ladies and gentlemen, Humberto Carrillo, huge win for this kid. We are back here on the Stomping Grounds kickoff show again. We just saw a great, phenomenal match right now between a young talent, Humberto Carrillo, and Andrade, a leaving star of Monday Night Raw, someone who's leaving Raw for ECW. But this next match here could see the end of another career here, a career here on Monday Night Raw. This is career in the WWE. Christian will take on Baron Corbin here tonight on Stomping Grounds. With Christian's career is on the line. Baron Corbin has just ended the career of Golda several weeks back, and he's no longer a member of WWE, and we will never see Goldust again in the WWE, and Baron Corbin has seen fit to that. Now Baron Corbin, proud of what he is able to do, has ran into Christian, and Christian told him, hey, you know what? I don't like you running around saying you can break tire anyone, you can break anyone, you can do whatever you want to know. Because here on Monday Night Raw, you got to understand your place in the totem pole. You beat Goldust. That's fine. It's my friend. That's cool. But you're not coming after me. You're not going to do anything to me, man. And Baron Corbin told Christian, you know, put the money, put your money where your mouth's at. And put your career on the line against me. Let me end your career too. Let me end another waste of TV time. Another talentless hack for me to end. And that's what's going to happen there tonight. And then we move on to another match, which I think a lot of fans are very excited. These two have gone at it before this year. These two have had several matches this year involving championships. But tonight, this one here is just to prove where they are at. Cesaro telling Daniel Bryan, I can see that hatred coming out of you. I can see that anger coming in out of you because you used to be a champion. You used to be a world champion. And I look at you now. You're nothing. You're nothing. And Daniel Bryan's like, I don't think I'm nothing. I actually beat Chris Jericho. I beat him in WrestleMania. I am still one of the top stars in Monday Night Raw. Cesaro and Daniel Bryan, two in-ring generals, two guys who can steal the show tonight. And I have that feeling. This match has Cesaro's a lot to say about this match. I'm not going to have enough time here to say it. But that match right here could be the show stealer of the night and definitely a match I can't wait to see again. And in a match where a Money in the Bank briefcase is on the line, Sheamus will defend that briefcase against the returning Seth Rollins. And Seth Rollins is on a warpath, well, as he says, to burn it down. Burn down what Triple H and the Authority have built. Something he used to wave proud. He used to wave that flag proudly, Seth Rollins, that he wanted to bring back the Authority and do everything. But Rollins was sent on a sabbatical. Rollins came back and decided, hey, you know what? I'm going to burn Raw down. I'm going to take Triple H out of power. And Sheamus, wanting to prove to Triple H where he stands in his loyalty, decided, how about I put you out of your misery, Rollins, and put the Money in the Bank briefcase on the line. And this match has a lot of potential tonight to see Triple H try to screw Seth Rollins over. I'm just saying what we're all thinking here. But I can't wait to see, can Seth Rollins take that briefcase away from Sheamus and become Mr. Money in the Bank? And then this one here. This is our main event for tonight. One last time, Sasha Banks, Charlotte Flair, the Raw Women's Championship on the line in a steel cage match. These two have been going at it for the Raw Women's Championship ever since the Raw draft. Stephanie McMahon has been doing everything in her power to give Charlotte Flair shot after shot after shot after shot at the championship. Sasha Banks, the resilient champion, the champion who is not afraid to defend her title, has been doing just that and defeating Charlotte Flair without a shadow of a doubt. Their match at Extreme Rules, hell, Banks was thrown off of a TV production truck and she still won the match. Banks tonight will have a tough challenge against Charlotte Flair. Banks asked for this matchup to make sure there is no interruptions, nobody stepping into this. But you gotta wonder where is Sasha Banks at in this matchup? Charlotte Flair giving an easy path here, relaxing schedule to this match. Sasha Banks, on the other hand, has been challenged, and Stephanie McMahon knows that this is maybe Charlotte Flair's night. And I hope to God this is the end of this feud. It's been great, but, you know, speaking of that main event, speaking of the main event of the kickoff show, a number one contenders match for the United States Championship. Tyler Breeze, Robert Roode, up next. And this all has come from Tyler Breeze coming out and saying he is the next best wrestling prospect in the world. And Robert Roode's like tired of him. He's like, hey, you can come out here and keep saying that over and over again, but the last match you had was about a couple months ago. So how about you lace up the boots, get in that ring against me? And Tyler Breeze said only there's one thing that can be on the line, and that's the number one contendership for the U.S. title. Stephanie McMahon granted it, and tonight we get this as our main event. for Stomping Grounds Kickoff Show. Tyler Breeze is about to be in the opportunity to become the number one contender for the United States Championship, a match that he's been telling us about for weeks, possibly years, because it feels like years that that's all he's ever done, come out and tell the world how he is the next hot prospect in fashion, wrestling, and in the entertainment business. That's Tyler Breeze for you. But tonight he's got to get through the glorious one, Bobby Roode, and some nasty words that Tyler Breeze has said about the attire, the wardrobe of Bobby Roode, and his nice. I feel like they're great, but he does not like his attire. He does not like that. But that's just cheap shots by Tyler Breeze, a man who has been just going around telling the world how good he is, and hasn't really got in the ring to prove it. Been lowering on that one match he had against Seth Rollins and AJ Styles. Robert Roode, ready to get to it here, ready to do what he has to do to be the best of the best. The man came from NXT, a former NXT champion, looking to climb his way up on Monday Night Raw, and what a better way than to become the United States Championship holder. But tonight, you got to get through Tyler Breeze to start that journey. Tonight, the United States Championship will also be defended when the champion Drew McIntyre takes on Shinsuke Nakamura, Bobby Lashley, and the phenomenal one, AJ Styles. You know, any one of these matchups that you can come up with, the number one contender and those champion, the man or not in the championship matchup, it's going to be, as Bobby Roode would like to say, you already know, so why should I say glorious? But you got to get through it. You can't overlook Tyler Breeze. And then I know Bobby Roode's not going to allow that to happen. He's a professional, one of the best professionals out there on the Monday Night Raw roster, looking to prove himself to the Raw locker room, looking to prove himself to the Raw leadership and the WWE universe here who are not familiar from him from NXT. Tyler Breeze, a former NXT champion too, a former NXT tag team champion alongside alongside Fandango. Both men went their separate ways now, and Raw's Tyler Breeze is here on Raw, and Fandango on SmackDown, not having much luck over there on SmackDown, as you would say. And these two are just taunting each other, just talking right now. And look at Tyler Breeze not doing much, and Bobby Roode's like, yeah, I'll do the same exact thing as you. You don't want to get in that ring and start fighting? Bobby Roode told me you can get the first punch on me, but and this is what Breeze does best. Breeze talks, and look at this. Look at Bobby winding him up. Oh, kick to the midsection in the middle of the glore. And now Bobby Roode's like, that's what I've been waiting for. You to take that first punch so I can start just beating the crap out of you. And now you got to wonder if Tyler Breeze was just all talking, had a one-night fluke of a match. And now Breeze counters it. Nice counter there by Breeze, switching it up now to his side here.
and Breeze using that bottom rope to great effectiveness. And now Tyler Breeze, look at this. This is not smart, Breeze. You can't let up. You can't let Robert Roode have a moment to breathe. This man is a professional. This man is a veteran. This man knows how to get wins just like that. And Tyler Breeze telling everybody, shoo away. Oh, there you go. That's what I've been talking. Look at the look at how he's just schooling Tyler Breeze right now. Glenn's been a vet in the business for about 20 years. You just don't take that away. You just don't not. You do not just not. Just you don't discredit that. You have to take him more serious, Tyler. If you want to win this, you have to take him seriously, and you have to understand who you're in the ring with. And Bobby Roode, though, is glorious chanting out there, and maybe you shouldn't be chanting as much neither. I'm telling you, the crowd, getting the crowd up and out of their seats at Tyler Breeze right now with a shot to the head, another shot to the head of Bobby Roode here, and here we go, Breeze now. Ooh, Breeze, shot to the midsection there. And now Breeze gets tossed outside. Bobby Roode again and got hit in the nuts, but he found a way. That's why you wear a cup. Smart man. Bobby Roode, the veteran himself, is doing that. And now the vet is taking care of Tyler Breeze. And look at Breeze. Both men veteran of the game, but both men looking to make their impact on Monday Night Raw in different ways. Both seasoning their trail. Breeze takes that shot to the outside, right to the steel post. Six count. This again, both of you getting counted gives none of you a shot at the championship. Just to let you know, Bobby. Eight count. The ref's on. Come on, man. You got to get back in the ring. And Bobby brings it back at the eight count here. And now Bobby Roode, who I feel like has been in control of most of the match. 75-25%, you know, that's what it is right now. I feel like Tyler Breeze got 25% of the match in his favor, even maybe less than that, and Robert Roode has been in control of this matchup the whole time. And now look, now here's a siding by Breeze, an offensive siding. Maybe he gets something together here. Nope. That's not bad at all. Tyler Breeze saying this match is over. I don't think it's over, man, but if you believe it. Tyler Breeze to the middle turnbuckle, waiting for Bobby, and oh come on, you gotta do something from there, man. Don't taunt him. Knee right there, and that's just disrespectful right there. And a pinfall here, trying to beat him with that knee right there, and Bobby Roode says, a one count's all you're gonna get from me, buddy boy. And now Bobby Robert Roode is behind him and drawing the punches again, and these punches laying into Tyler Breeze, and Breeze, snake eyes, got snake eyes right there, and here comes Robert Roode. Oh, he just went, that's Tyler Breeze's speed, just says, let me dip and let you fly outside of the ring. Tyler Breeze becomes number one contender with the count out of Bobby Roode, Robert Roode, whatever you want to call him, Mr. Roode. Tyler Breeze wins like this, and Robert Roode getting a moment outside to breathe, and look at Tyler Breeze saying, this face right here, the future face of the United States Championship, of the United States 2. And now Robert Roode turns it around. Spinebuster double A! Let's go! That's enough! Then a kick out by Tyler Breeze. Just gotta love how that spinebuster comes out of nowhere and almost gets the win for Roode. And this is a kickoff show tonight that's gonna bring you so many of Raw's best challengers, best champions, the best of the best tonight on Stomping Grounds here. This is a kickoff match, a superplex for the number one contendership of the United States Championship. And a pinfall here, possibly the winner, a kick out by Breeze. But in a pay-per-view that is fitting the name of what these two are trying to do, they are trying to, it's a Stomping Grounds. These men are trying to prove that they belong here. On Monday Night Raw, want to show the world what they can do. And Breeze right now is in a world of hurt. The old cliche, a world of hurt, because he needs to figure himself out here. Because Robert Roode has not stopped. Robert Roode is looking to do everything and anything to win this match now. But here comes Tyler Breeze. Kicked! Oh, super kick! Supermodel kick!
And a supermodel kick almost took the win away from Rude. And that supermodel kick comes out from out of nowhere. And he missed a clothesline. Maybe he's not feeling it right now. The speed again of Tyler Breeze. Suplex. I call it a supermodel super kick. And then he still got the supermodel kick too. But right now, Tyler Breeze. Oh, the counter into a power slam. What a counter. And now Rude. Rude says, no, not like that. Rude's like, I got to win this. And he's going to go for the glorious DDT. Oh, no, he's trying to get the crowd here. Panning to the crowd. Big mistake. Tyler Breeze on Prettier. There it is. Your face has been lifted and your win has been taken because you didn't do it. Oh, kick out by Rude.
Tyler Breeze. Thought that he got it. Thought he had it. Thought he had him won. Thought he had this match in the bag. But right now, Rude is showing something else. And the big kick down the side of the head of Rude. And now Tyler Breeze trying to close this one out. Trying to put himself on chop. Trying to be the guy that walks out of here with the win. And a number one contendership for the United States Championship. DDT there by Breeze. And now Tyler. Where you go? Where's Tyler going here? Mr. Breeze. Breeze with a big leg drop. Tyler Breeze about to do it. About to pull it. Oh, that's a big time kick there. Kick out by Robert Roode. Bob Robert Roode. I have so many names to call this man here. The veteran. Roode counters there. And now Breeze takes that one out. And now Rude turns him around here. Suplex did this to him earlier in the matchup, but this time it's just to show him where he is at right now. Rude still feeling good about his chances here. Rude, snapmare down. Neckbreaker coming soon. Neckbreaker there. And the supermodel is feeling the effects right now from Rude. And a kick out there at 1.5. Rude tried to catch him off guard there with that. And now Rude says, I got something for you, baby. Spaw, power, quick power slam right there. And Rude is very, very well inversed with those power slams. Makes him look like a thing of beauty. And big shots again from Rude. While Breeze trying to figure it out, man. The shots being laid in right now. Rude, what is this? Oh, you're going to Flapjack City. You're going to be picked up and dropped off like that, my man. And now, Rude went for a cutter. Nothing there. Breeze goes for a... Oh! That's not bad at all. It's a good way for Breeze to get back control of the matchup. And now Rude says, I'm going to counter this. But now Breeze says, I'm going to counter this. And I'm going to give you this suplex. No, Rude says, I'm going to give you this here. This is for you, buddy boy. Your knee... Oh, the knee of Breeze. You don't want your knees to be double-A spine bustered again. Pinfall. I don't know if this is the end. I don't think it is. A kick out, though, by Breeze. This is the third one he's delivered. He's delivering these ones like this, man. He's not getting through with him. Just again, the supermodel kick. The supermodel super kick. Oh, kick out there by Rude. Both men have tried that move. Their secondary best move in the bank. And their options of moves. It hasn't worked yet now, has it? But Breeze looks like he's going to go for that and Prettier again. No, this time Rude said, I see what's going on here. Rude said, you didn't see this one, though. Glorious DDT! And that's in the middle of the ring. Ladies and gentlemen, this one is a... Okay. Okay now. I guess never mind. It's not over because Breeze says, I'm going to kick out of that. And now Breeze... Says, let me get you with an Unprettier. No. Rude's like, there is no Unprettier coming anymore. Let me get you at the top rope there. And now I'm watching here, observing these two men. And Rude can't get that one. There's a look at that super. What is going on here? What is going on? That's the Undisputed Era's music. Both men used to be in NXT, but Rude most frequently in NXT. Rude!
Punch to the head. Now Tyler Breeze, but I don't know what the hell that was. Now Rudo, roll up! Roll up! And I can't count by Tyler. Again, I think the crowd here is just interested to see what the hell was that. Why was the Undisputed Era's music playing? Glorious DDT! Oh! Oh, Breeze says no! Breeze says I'll kick out however I want to. And right now, Rude. Rude is just thinking of telling the crowd, what do I do? What do you do in a moment like that? What can you do? I don't know who played the Undisputed Era's music or what that was all about, but it did not work because both men are still trying to figure out who's going to get the win. And over the head right there again, Tyler Breeze now says, I got to get this one, man. He's like, I got to get it. I've already kicked out of one glorious DDT. Let me do it again. Leg drop. And I kick out by Rude. And Rude, no! Rude, what? Oh, look at this. This man going for another one. One, two, three. Robert Rude is the number one contender for the United States Championship. But I'm sorry, but there is a couple of questions that need to be answered. I'm just going to throw it out there. What was it with that Undisputed Era's music? Ladies and gentlemen, I hope we get more answers on Monday Night Raw for that situation. But we're getting ready to start Stomping Grounds. And in a night that just looks like anything can go and anything will go. What is going on here tonight? I'm at a loss for words, but Rude, the new number one contender for the United States Championship.